What is a Christian calling? Make it sure that while you have the light, believe your God is a loving Father. The light God has come into you to lighten your heart with the truth which will set you free. Your God is a loving Father. Your God is all powerful. Your God is all knowing. Yes. While you walk in the light, yes, believe in the light, and second, and become the children of light. Who celebrates light? Who celebrates Deepavali? Big fellows, they are putting bush, come on. But children, they fly. They see the stars. They call it Mattapu. You become the children of light. You are not busy with the bombs. You enjoy the light. Enjoy the light. You put some other things also. You lit it on the ground and you just throw it. It moves round, 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 round. You are around the light. If you move with the light, you become the children of light. Close your eyes for a minute. Place your hands over your heart. Take the word of God inside you. You are not given the spirit of fear. Rather, spirit of loving. You have a loving Father. You are given the spirit of power. You belong to God Almighty, all-knowing. And you are given the spirit of discipline. You don't allow anything and everything to decide you. You become the carriers of light. You become shining in the light. Ask the Lord for that grace. Have you heard what I spoken about you? Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? Can you see with my eyes? Have you heard what I said about you? Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are?
Can't you see with my eyes? Have you heard what I said about you? Do you know who you are?
And if I am the shepherd, then you are my sheep, for whom I will lay down my life. If you go away from me, I will search for you until I'll find you. Do you know who you are?
Who you are?
Can you see?
Can you see?
My eyes.
With my eyes.
Have you heard?
Have you heard
what I said about you?
What I said about you?
Do you know?
Do you know
who you are?
Who you are?
And if I am the vine, then you are my branches. In you I will bring many fruits. I may prune you and cut your branches, that you may bear much, much fruits.
Do you know who you are?
Can you see with my eyes? Have you heard what I said about you? Do you know who you are? Now the enemy manage to enter into the life of a servant of God and took him away from God, took him away from the place where God has kept him, took him away from the ministry that he had given him, and took him to the place of a broom tree. It is a tree, but it doesn't fulfill the purpose of the tree. There are no shade. It's like a broom under which the snakes and scorpions stay. Satan takes a servant of God to his own abode. To his own abode. It is the desire of evil spirit to capture the children of God and to take to the hellfire and burn their souls. He rejoices, take the soul of every human being and drinks the blood and throws them into the fire which never quenches. Yes, the moment we lose the fear of God, the fear of the enemy captures us. It is not that life is not without problems. We read in the book of Genesis, chapter 39, where a young man called Joseph was being attacked, but the woman frightens him. If you don't sin with me, I will destroy you. I will put you into the jail. He overcomes the fear that brought by the enemy with a fear of God. He is not becoming victim to the fear that is brought by the enemy. You have to overcome the darkness with the light. If you walk in the light, the darkness will not overtake you. With a fear of God, he says, how can I do which is displeasing to my God? So the frame of reference is God. The frame of reference is to please my God, to do what is pleasing to my God. When that becomes the goal of my mind, the aim of my life, the goal of a Christian living, I want to do what pleasing to my God. Let anything happen. Let it be any cost. I'm here for my God. Why? Why God can die and tell me that I am for you? Why can't I tell I am for you, Lord? When I respond to him, I am for you, Lord. Why should he ask me, do you love me? I say, yes, I am loving you. All my life is for you. When that becomes not saying, my life becomes a response. It is there. The Holy Spirit is abiding. It is there. We are born again. It is not simply you drown with the water. Either yesterday you received the child baptism, so now you go into the relief. Next moment, you are falling in sin. It is not the type of baptism you receive. The baptism is you have to be born again in the Spirit. Born again with the presence of God. Born again with the truth of God. It is not your the way of. So all those who are drowned in the baptism, they are all going to heaven? No. It is not how you are received baptism. How are you living with the presence of God? Is the light shines in you that the darkness may not overtake you? My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.